The Prime Minister now says there should be consequences for lying to Canadians. I guess he'll find out in October. But in his letter threatening to sue the Conservative leader, he says that the former Attorney General never told him that the political interference in an ongoing criminal proceeding was entirely inappropriate. But the Prime Minister admitted to this House last week that, in fact, she told him that directly to his face. So he says there should be consequences for lying to Canadians. When will the Prime Minister take us to court so he can experience just what those are?
I encourage members to be judicious, of course, in the words they choose in this House. Honourable Government House Leader, order.
Mr. Speaker, I appreciate your reminder that members should be judicious in their wording, and that's exactly why outside of this chamber you're not always there to monitor the situation. But Canadians can have confidence that when the Leader of the Official Opposition is misleading Canadians, we will not stand idly by. And that's exactly why the Leader of the Official Opposition was put on notice. After he was put on notice, he deleted tweets. He actually edited his wording to be more judicious, just as you have reminded all members to do. This is not the first time the Conservatives have done this. They did this in December after the Minister of Innovation had served them notice. Thank you.
The Honourable Member for Chilliwack-Hope.
In the letter where the Prime Minister threatens to sue the Conservative leader, he says that it's a lie that the Clerk of the Privy Council pressured the former Attorney General and made it clear that her job was on the line. Well, Canadians could hear clearly on an audio recording that the Clerk of the Privy Council said exactly that. Truth is an absolute defence, and every word of the Conservative leader's statement on the Liberals SNC-Lavalin scandal is true. If the Prime Minister believes otherwise, when will we see him in court?
The Honourable Government House Leader.
I appreciate the opportunity to once again remind Canadians that all information is public. Why is that information public, Mr. Speaker? Because the Prime Minister waives solicitor-client privilege as well as cabinet confidence. All meetings of the Justice Committee members that they had on this issue were in public so that Canadians could decide for themselves. And they know very well who is misleading Canadians. That member talks a big game. But in February, when it came to comments on this file, it was the leader, his leader, the leader of the official opposition, that actually retracted that statement. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.